So how does all this new technology come together? If you've decided that using an LED volume is going to be a good fit for your production, how do you get started? And what does the virtual production process look like? Let's take it step by step. It all begins on the development and discovery phase. The virtual production team can help with creating a methodology assessment. This is crucial to determining if using an LED volume is the right tool for your project and how your content will be generated.
Yeah, I think we just make this room cluttered with stuff.
Once you've decided to move forward, it's time to bring the project to the virtual art department, also known as the VAD team. The art department works in conjunction with the VAD team to design and realize your set environments in a 3D game engine. Keep in mind, this is for 3D or real-time on-set virtual production. We'll discuss the 2D workflow in a future chapter.
So VAD is an acronym, V-A-D, for Virtual Art Department. The Virtual Art Department are primarily responsible for creating the virtual art, the content that will go on the LED wall or that will be used in a virtual scouting scenario. So it's not too dissimilar to post-VFX or animation, where you're kind of creating those CG environments, but the difference with virtual production is that this is being created for the use for real time and to be shot through a camera and to be in an immersive environment. And ultimately they will be responsible from the initial concept phase of creating this virtual world right through to creating the content that will end up on the wall and will be shot as final and camera.
It sounds simple enough, but virtual Rome was not built in a day. There are layers to this process. The foundation of the environment typically starts as a white box or roughly textured model, used to define the scale and scope of your environment. The VAD may work in conjunction with a concept artist, and as notes from the creative team and additional design elements are added, the scene evolves into what will ultimately become your final effect. On a traditional production, you need to go out and scout your location. But since we're working in the virtual world now, we can take advantage of virtual scouting. This is where we figure out how the physical set is going to be built out. That includes determining how exactly the physical LED volume fits into the big picture. When the layout has been locked in, blocking is done in the virtual environment with tools such as previs, virtual cameras, or even VR headsets. Then you can take a first pass at virtual camera blocking. Practice those moves. Now that the virtual environment has been built, the director of photography can begin their virtual pre-light. The environments are typically divided up based on where the live and virtual elements will interact. These areas are commonly known as hot zones. Defining hot zones helps departments know where to focus their resources. After the concept has been fully tested and locked in, the art department can move forward with the physical construction. We may have advanced technology, but in order to create the most authentic effect, it's about blending the digital with the tangible. Communication between all departments is crucial throughout this process.
So when the physical meets the virtual, that's when the magic happens. That's when you ground virtual to reality. We are so used to watching movies where we see physical assets, we see real locations, we see things around us all day. When you put assets on an LED wall, for example, if there's no human interaction with the things surrounding them, soon the illusion is gonna be broken, and we start thinking that those assets, they look fake, the environments, they look fake. So to ground the audience to reality, we add real assets where a talent, an actor can walk and can touch. And by doing that, our brains tell us that, hey, that's a real scene. Then we don't pay attention to what's happening in the background, but instead we pay attention to the action, which is the most important thing and what's valuable that the cameras capture.
Physical sets need to fit into virtual environments, and virtual sets need to work with the physical. Making mid-ground and foreground elements from the physical set visible in the frame helps create depth and blends the physical environment with the wall. Anything that an actor physically interacts with needs to be practically built. No matter how skilled your talent may be,
thank you.
If they're supposed to be opening a book or moving a piece on a chessboard, they're still gonna need that prop.
Zombie action.
After all that time and work we just spent creating a virtual environment, we don't want to run into any surprises on set. So make sure to review the content on the LED wall through the specific production camera and lenses you're going to be using, including the physical camera blocking. It's the final piece of the puzzle, so don't skip this step.
They have a trick that they do all the work before the shoot day, and what happens is they know exactly what the type of shots they're going to achieve. They know where the lights are going to be. They know where the crane is going to go. They do that prep. By utilizing a virtual version of your camera and your lenses in a real-time environment allows you to be super creative, and you make sure that like the creative choices you made, they will move on to post-production.
Finally comes the practical pre-light on the stage itself, where the set is lit to match the pre-established digital lighting. Time to get up in that grid and rig your lights. Camera placement is pre-rigged by the camera tracking team, and all key heads of department and directors are present for approval. Whew, we made it. Now comes the easy part. Oh, wait, it's production.